Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see the difference between the newly launched Poco X3 and the Poco X2. So let's see how much is the difference and is it worth to upgrade from the X2. So let's begin. Okay, so guys, first of all we will talk about the display here. What's the difference between the both the displays here? Both of them has the Gorilla Glass 5 on the top. The protection here is Gorilla Glass 5 HDR 10, but the Poco X3 display has the 240Hz touch response rate and the X2 has 120Hz touch response. So that's an upgrade, and the display size on both of them is just the same 6.67 inch display, and resolution here is the 2400 by 1080p pixels. That is Full HD Plus display, and the X3 has a center punch hole display and while the X2 had the dual punch hole display. Then talking about the processor here on the Poco X3, that it is a little bit upgrade from 730G to 732G. So that's a little bit upgrade, that's only 15% of upgrade in the performance, and that you will not notice any difference in the day-to-day usage. And the GPU on both of them here is the same Adreno 618 GPU, so the PUBG performance on both of them will be just the same here. Then talking about the fingerprint scanner on both of them, you get the side mounted fingerprint scanner, and that works fluidly and absolutely fine, and as it is a physical fingerprint scanner, so it will be a fast enough. And the display here is the LCD panel on both of them, so there is no in-display fingerprint scanner here. Then talking about the back panel here, in terms of back panel, the X3 is a little bit downgrade because it is having a plastic back instead of glass back. In the X2 you were getting the glass back, that was Gorilla Glass 5 protection, so you are getting the plastic back in the X3 and you will get scratches easily on the X3. And talking about the body here, like the build quality and weight, and in terms of that, the thickness here is 10 mm and the X2 had 8.79 mm, that is 8.8. so the phone is very thick and heavy here also, because the X3 weight is 225 grams and the X2 was 208 grams. I personally use the Poco X2 and the 208 grams also feels heavy in hand and hefty. So the 225 grams of weight will be a heavy phone. Like, you will take a long time to get used to it because it's a heavy phone and a large display phone. So it's a big and hefty phone. And then talking about the battery here, the battery you get on the X3 is 6000 mAh battery, and that is the reason the phone is so thick and heavy. And on the X2 you get a 4500 mAh battery. So many users were complaining about the battery life on the Poco X2. I personally use the Poco X2 and I had made a video on the detailed review on the Poco X2 battery life here. The card will be up available here, you can go watch it out. So that is a little bit issue of battery drain in Poco X2 with 120Hz display. So they have increased to 6000 mAh. So that is great. And the battery on the Poco X3 will be just great because it has the dynamic display and refresh rate, which is on whatever the content you are watching here. So if you are watching a video or something on YouTube, then the display refresh rate will switches to 50Hz. And if you are consuming the content that is available in 90Hz, then it will switch to 90Hz. And if that is available in 120, then it will switch to 120Hz. So this is great and it will save a lot of battery life. So that's great. Then talking about the charger here, you get in the box and the Poco X3 is 33W fast charger here. And on the X2, you are getting 27W fast charger. So that's great. Then talking about the speakers here, on the X2, you get a single bottom firing speaker, but on the X3 you are getting a stereo speaker. So that's just great that at this price point you are getting a stereo speaker. So brands are getting stereo speakers at this price, so that's great and amazing because stereo speaker sounds just amazing. Then talking about the camera here, the camera here is also a little bit downgrade in my opinion, because on the X2 you were getting the Sony IMX686 sensor which has support for 4K 60 FPS, And on the X3, you are getting Sony IMX 682 sensor, which does not have 4K 60fps support. Stock camera does not give the 4K 60fps option here, but you can obviously use some third-party apps which give you support for the 4K 60fps, and it is working absolutely fine. So that will, and if you use Gcam, the camera quality on both of them will be just amazing. Then the wide angle camera here is a bit upgraded from X2. On the X2 you were getting 8 megapixel wide angle lens, and on the X3 you are getting the 13 megapixel, and the field of view is both of them is almost the same, 119 degree field of view. So the wide angle lens here is a bit upgraded, and then the last two cameras are just useless, 2 megapixel depth sensor and 2 megapixel macro lens. Then talking about the front camera here, on the front you get a center punch hole camera on the X3, that is the same 20 megapixel lens, same as the X2. X2 had the dual punch hole camera here, dual selfie camera, 20 plus 2 megapixel. The 2 megapixel another camera was just the useless depth sensor here. Talking about the other features here, on the X3 you get a notification light. On the X3 you don't get the notification light, and the liquid cooling technology here is a bit upgraded from the X2, and the Bluetooth version here is upgraded from 5.0 to 5.1. On the X3 you get Bluetooth 5.1, and on the X2 you are getting 5.0. So that's it guys, these were the differences from the X2 and the upgrades from the X2 over X3. The prices are just the same. So the base variant here is just an amazing 664 one at 17k is just an amazing deal. So that's great. If you want to buy, then you can go with the X3. But the users who are currently having the X2, I don't think they should upgrade, because you get a plastic back, the cameras here are a little bit downgraded, and the moreover you are getting a stereo speaker, and that's it. So guys, that's it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and goodbye.